reference to a valuation officer. Now, what can happen in some cases is that, you know, there could be assets for which circumstances may arise where, you know, the valuation might need to be referred to the valuation officer. Why? Because maybe because of the nature of the asset, the complexities, or certain other circumstances, it might just be required that, you know, some assets valuation has to be carried out by some other expert other than the assessing officer. So in these cases, the AO may refer to the matter to the valuation officer, but just to ensure that, you know, the AO does not exercise his power indiscriminately. In the sense, in every case, he just not keep on running around the valuation officer. There are some guidelines, there are some circumstances under which he can make a reference to the valuation officer. So let us see what are the objective for this. In order to ascertain the fair market value of a capital asset for computing capital gains, AO may refer the valuation of a capital asset to a valuation officer. Right? Because unless and until this asset is valued fairly, then the capital gains cannot be computed in a objective manner. And you know, at times there are people, there are assessees who might just want to bring this down value to a lower number, because then accordingly they'll be paying lower taxes. To cover these kind of situation, the AO has the power to refer the matter to the valuation officer. So let us see what are the cases when reference can be made to the valuation officer. The first case is assessee's valuation estimated by a registered valuer. So even if the assessee produces some kind of a valuation certificate from a registered valuer, the AO is of an opinion that the value so claimed is less than the fair market value. I'm not saying every person is unscrupulous, but it might just be that, you know, some registered valuer would have done a value which AO believes is less. In that case, he can refer the matter to a valuation officer to see whether the report is correct or not. And the second case is that AO is of the opinion in any other case where, which means the registered value report has not been obtained, the AO is of the opinion that the fair market value of the asset exceeds value claimed by the assessee by rupees 25,000. Right? So let's say assessee says the value is 2 lakh, while the assessing officer believes this is 2,50,000. So the value exceeds by 50,000, and therefore he can refer this matter. The next is nature of the asset and other relevant circumstances requires valuation to be carried out by the valuation officer. So let's say you are looking at a valuation of a brand. Now that is very difficult, and the AO may not possess the necessary expertise. So the nature of the asset itself warrants that some expert should be brought in. And in that case, the AO can refer the matter to the valuation officer. Now, once this AO refers the matter to the valuation officer, then the report of the valuation officer shall be binding on the AO. He cannot say that, okay, the value you've determined is less, I need to charge a higher value. No. If once you've made a reference, once the value has been determined, then that is binding on the AO. So which means that if this value is less than the value which is submitted by the assessee or the registered valuer, which was this case, then he has to obtain, he cannot say, no, now I'll go to someone else to find out a different value. Right?